So we are in the process of establishing classification of surfaces. And last time we began with the canonical polygons and carried out two of the steps in the reduction process. One was to get pairs of type 1 which are adjacent eliminated. The second one was to see that there is only one vertex class. All the vertices on the canonical polygon should be identified to a single point. So this we have achieved. Now the next step, three more steps I may say. So step three here now, to make any pair of edges of type 2 adjacent. Okay. So that means that we are assuming there is a pair of adjacent type 2. There is a pair of type 2. It may not be adjacent. If it's adjacent, there is nothing to do. If it's not adjacent, what is the meaning of that? There will be an edge A here, and then there will be some sequence, okay? And then the edge A occurs again, okay? A followed by A and capital A followed by A, and again another gap here. If B or A is empty, then A and this A will be adjacent. So essentially, you must assume that B and A are non-empty. Okay. So this may be any length, this may be any length, doesn't matter. So what I do, I take the tip of first A, the tip of the second A. So it's a convex polygon, so you can join them by a straight line, okay, to take that one. So name it as C, and I'm going to cut it along that. So this polygon will be cut along this line. The top portion here, this beta, alpha and beta, so two parts. Beta is kept as it is. The top portion is turned around. Actually, you have turned it around. Okay. Through pi by 4, so that this C, which is directed like this, is now turning around, comes to be directed like this. That is not the object. The object is to bring this A, which is downward arrow, to match this A, which is upward arrow. So match them and identify these two edges. Okay, so these two parts of the polygon are identified now. Okay, to another thing, which may not be a convex polygon. That is not a problem for us. All that we need is the sequence, and then we rewrite the convex polygon. That's what we do. So what has happened? A has disappeared. A, these two have disappeared, but a new edge has come, which is of type C under C. Okay, so this is the step three. So we have brought this together. Now again, we look at the rest of the sequence, whether there is any type 2 which is not adjacent. Again, we do the same thing. When we do that, this whole thing will be in one part, either in A part or in B part of this one. So whatever is we have brought it, that will not get disturbed. So that is the whole point here. So this way, repeating this process again and again, all the edges of type 2 will come adjacent they may not be together. Okay, all of them may not. Each of them will be adjacent. CC, then some gap, BB, some gap, AA, like that. So that is the idea of this step three. And I have explained how to do that. Okay, so this is what we do. What the corresponding relation code is, look at this one, A, capital B. That is the sequence, gets converted into, you can start from wherever you like, C, D, A inverse, okay, the other way around. Okay, this B, that's precisely what you have to see. A, capital A, B, is C, C, B, A inverse. A inverse means, if A is, say, A1, A2, AN, then you have to write it's AN inverse, A2 inverse, AN inverse, AN minus 1 inverse, A1 inverse. So that is the inverse sequence. Okay, exactly the opposite direction you have to take. Note that such an operation does not disturb some of the other pairs, BB, CC, etc., which is already present. Therefore, repeated application of this will make all the pairs of type to adjacent. Of course, it may be necessary to perform step one again, namely a new AA inverse, the type one, might have appeared, which are adjacent. You just do the same thing, process of folding it up and eliminating them. Okay. On the other hand, what happens is the number of vertex class will never be more. Okay, this is what you have to observe. Number of vertex class will never be more. Look at here, for example. So all these vertices were in the same class, one single class. What I have done, I have cut it here. Okay, so this vertex, end of this one, and beginning of A, wherein maybe you might be, they may off go into different class. It will not happen because this beginning of A is end of beginning of C. Okay, beginning of C was the point here. So that is not in a different class. Okay, now, so the other one is end of A here, okay. End of A here, they have come together already. So only one vertex class will be there in the new thing also. Check that there is only one vertex class. So that's what they have to satisfy. Okay, at this stage, step three is also done. So let us take a look what is happening. At this stage, there may be no pair, okay, of edges of type one left. Then what is the meaning of this? Everything is AA, BB, CC, and so on. Okay. That means that we have the list three, A1, A1, A2, A2, A2. This is the list three. So it is canonical. This is a normal form. So they're done. So what is the other case left out? The other case is precisely there is at least one pair of type 1 and they are not adjacent. Okay. So what to do with that one? That is the point. Okay. So this is the step 4, handling a pair of edges of type 1. Suppose there is at least one pair of edges of type 1, say labeled A and then the other one somewhere A inverse. Definitely, if it is adjacent, we have already eliminated it. So it is not adjacent. Okay, but A, some capital A, then A inverse, some capital B, and then that. So A and B, A capital B may not be, should not be empty. This is what the meaning of this one. So P has the form as shown in figure 36. A, something non-empty. A inverse, okay, and something non-empty. All right. If V or A is empty, then I can immediately eliminate by step one. So that's not a point. So we can, if no edge in A is identified any edge in B, now let me examine what happens. So there must be some identification. Each edge here is identified some other edge. But if suppose edges inside A are identified within themselves, namely inside A itself, B inside B itself, then what happens? Look at this endpoint here, the endpoint here. That goes to one single class, which is coming from A. This endpoint, the beginning and beginning of A, they will be in a different class, because A, when you identify A, they are not getting identified. They will be in a thing coming out of B. There is no identification from A to B. That means that there will be two vertex classes. That is not allowed now, because we have already made one vertex class. Therefore, some edge here must have identified some edge here, which will make finally all the vertex class single vertex class. All the vertices being identified. So one of the edges here must be identified one of the edges here. Okay, therefore, what we get is a better idea, namely this figure one here. A fine, inside this upper part there will be some B which will be identified with a B here. So A, B, little B, capital B, capital A in A inverse, this one, this is C, and this is again B and B inverse. Okay, B is this way, B inverse this way. D and A. Okay, it cannot be B because B and B are all adjacent. So AA, BB, both of them are pairs of type 1. Such a thing is called interlocked pair of type 1. Interlocked means what? They are not together. They are A to A, there is something in between. B and B, something in between, A and something in between, and so on. Okay? If these are empty, then there is nothing to prove. Okay? So you better assume they are non-empty. Otherwise, whatever you are doing is already somewhat useless thing. Whatever, it is already achieved what you want to do. So let us see what we want to do now. So this time, so cut top of A to top of to line from top of A to top of A. Okay, earlier we did top of A to top here all the time, right? Top of A, top of A. Cut off this part. All right. Whatever remains is drawn here, this alpha. This beta will be now brought back so that B and B are getting identified. Just slide it down and put it here. Identify the edges B and P. The new sequence will be what? Now you just read from wherever you like. Okay. So it starts B, and then C is the new edge, then A. Okay. So this B is inside now. Okay. So this B, you pick up from here, D, A, this new edge C, A, and then C. Okay, that is a new sequence. You redraw it as a convex polygon here in a diagram 3. Same thing I have to see. I have now A to D. This is a black box, right? We don't know what sequence it is. Some sequence, non-empty sequence. So you write it as A to D, AD. Okay, this is A, C, A. This will be what? This is CB. Okay. Now we have this C and CA, which is again type 1. C, C inverse, right? So from top to top, I mean, end point to end point, draw this line D, cut it here. Okay, now bring this A and A together. Okay, that means what? This portion, alpha portion, has to be brought here and turn it around. Okay, so that A and A coincide. So new phenomena here, what it is, C, okay, C, D inverse, C inverse, AD, CB, D. Okay, so you can redraw it and then you see that DC, D inverse, C inverse. So this whole thing is now together. And then ACD is something. DC, D inverse, C inverse. Okay, so there is no in between things here now. So this is the best thing you can do. Of course, you can't bring them together. D, D inverse will not come together. There will be C in between. D, C, D inverse, C inverse. So this was precisely the sequence for the torus. So this portion of the surface will give you a torus, and then this will be connected some with something more. So we will transform the polygon so that the two interlocked pairs of edges become consecutive. Okay. So the corresponding thing is starting with A, capital A, B, capital B, A inverse C, B inverse D, finally got turned into this one, ADB, ADCB something, DC, D inverse, C inverse. You can call it as XY, X inverse, Y inverse, if you want. What label you do is immaterial. Okay. Now look at ADCB. Do the same operation on this part by calling this as something nice already. This will never be disturbed. If there is a pair here which is not adjacent, you perform the same operation here again. So keep doing this. All the interlocked systems of type 1, they will come together. Okay, so this is what we have. By repeated application of this, get the canonical polygon of the form A1, B1, A1 inverse, B1 inverse, A2, B2, A2 inverse, B2 inverse, and so on, AM, BM, AM inverse. And then all the other ones are type 2, C1, C1, C2, C2, C3, C3, CN, CN. If either M is 0 or N is 0, then M is 0 means it is type 3, list 3, and N is 0 means list 2. Okay, we had in the classification, we had 3 of them. First list was just the A inverse, which corresponded to the sphere 2, S. Okay, then list 2 was only this kind of things up to AM inverse, BM inverse. The list 3 was this one. This is combination, this is neither in, it is not in the list. So this is not normal. So we have to do one more hat trick here to make it a normal sequence. Okay, so that will be the last step to be performed. Handling the case of mixed type. Unmixed type means what? Either only AA inverses are there or C1, C1, C2, C2 are there. These are type 1, these are type 2. If both of them are there, what to do? Okay. So now what we do is, we concentrate on the middle portion is here. AM, BM, AM inverse, BM inverse, C1, C2. One of the type 1 pair here, and the other one is, you know, type two of them together, okay? You have to take, you can't take just one of them. And the other one is type 2 pair. So what to do with this? Okay, you will convert this one into entirely type 2. Okay, so that is the whole idea. Combining results of the two cut and paste done in figure, we obtain the following relation. Okay, so what I am calling is A here, up to here AM minus 1 BM minus 1 AM inverse AM minus 1 inverse BM minus 1 inverse, you call it capital A. Then you take this part, call it as ABA inverse B inverse. Then take the C1, 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 call it as just CC. So this portion is getting converted into A into XY, XZ, YZ. Okay. So let us see how this gets. So this is what it is. A, B, A inverse, B inverse. Okay. Then C, C. And then a big gap, which I have not written down anything. This is capital A. You can write as capital A here. A, B, A inverse, B inverse, C, C. Okay. Look at the tip of A. Okay. To tip of C. So you have to make this guess where to cut and so on. This is not at all obvious. Okay. So there are two of them. You have to break this C at this point. So you must be really worried because you have brought this one with so much of effort. Now you are asking, cut it. Okay. So you have to do that. Cut it here. Okay. And bring this part, beta part is kept as it is. Bring this one on this side so that this A and this A are together. Okay. This part of A and this part of these two things together. Identify them. So this A disappears. What is the new thing that appears? This D will appear now. Okay. D is this way and you have turned it around. So this will become downward here. Okay, D inverse, B, D, C, and then this capital A here, which was blank thing here. Okay, after that, what you have this part here now, B inverse and C, ending with D here. Okay, rewrite this one. Okay, just like this way. Now one more cut you have to do. Look at the starting part of B to the end of C. Okay, B, D, C are there already. Cut it along this. This is E now. Cutting along E. Okay. This portion is brought back here so that the C here will match C here. So you are actually destroying the old C. Old A, but you are getting some new of them. Okay. So what you get is now E, D inverse, E again, some gap. Okay. Then this is what? This is B inverse, D inverse, P inverse. Okay. You better start from here and keep reading and then capital A at the last. Okay. B inverse, D inverse, P inverse. Okay, then E, T inverse E. All right. So we can now apply three successively to make this into A, XX, YY, ZZ. Finally, what we have got is this process. We have got A into XY, XZ, YZ. So what I'm doing, I'm instead of writing like this, this is A, this is X. Write B inverse, but you write it as X. X, Y. Okay. Again, you are getting X here because B inverse is X. Okay. X, Y, X, and new one, Z. Okay. So that's why this sequence is X, Y, X, Z, and then Y, Z. Okay. And then Y, Z. So this is not what we wanted. Okay. It should be XX, YY, ZZ. But that you can always do by step three. Right? Wherever you have XY, X, so this X and X can be brought together. Okay? And anyway, there are XX, YY, ZZ, three of them. All the three of them can be brought together. XX, YY, ZZ, by step three. Okay, so you have to repeat step 3 again to make it what we want. So what has happened finally is the following. We started with one AB, AB inverse of this type and one of this one. Okay, rest of this part and this part, you could have taken all this part in single here and assumed that this is at the end by cyclically permuting. Okay, then that all that A remains as it is, and this part becomes XX, YY, ZZ. So it becomes three pairs of type 2. Okay, so 1 plus 1 here, one type of this one, one part of this one, give you three pairs of type 2. Whatever is remaining, you repeat the same process again on that. All right. Each time you see there are plenty of type 2 things to mix with that one till all the these AIs and BIs have disappeared one by one. If there's only one by now, it would have become one here, one here, it would have become 3CC, 3C17, C2, C2, C3, C3. There are two of them, again, three more, and so on. Okay, each time with mixing with this one, this will convert into two of the sequence. Okay, by repeating this process, so in the middle, you keep changing. That's what I have told you. In middle, this will be replaced by XX, YY, ZZ, and rewrite the sequence, this part. Again, take the next one, and you make it XX, YY, ZZ, and rewrite. Okay, finally, you will be left with X1, X1, X2, XK, XK, YK, XK, XK, repeated. Okay, this will be the sequence. Okay, actually, this K will be precisely equal to whatever N was there. Each of these M will get into two of them, so 2N plus N. Okay, so this completes the proof of part A of the theorem 6.4a. Starting with the polygon, the first case is AA inverse, which is S2. We don't want to do anything. It is declared as normal. Otherwise, what should happen? It will be of the feature 2. Let me just go back. The list 2 is like a repeated torus, A1, B1, A1 inverse, B1 inverse, AG, BG, AG inverse, BG inverse. The second one is A1, A1, A2, A2, etc. projective space, repeated projective space. Okay. The second part is any two distinct members of this list give surfaces which are non-homeomorphic. So that is the part that will be good. Okay. All the surfaces you can see here is one part, which is already a big thing. Now, the list is not a redundant list. There is no unnecessary elements. No, duplication is not there. This is what you have to assure. So that part we will prove using fundamental group. It will give a very easy proof. Then just to justify all this homology and so on, we should use simplicial homology and give a proof. We shall also give a proof which using cellular homology. Okay. So today we will stop here. Thank you.